Good afternoon and welcome to WRAMG TV 12 TV 97's coverage of Belmont and Kossuth softball. We're live at Lady Aggie Field. We're in, of course, Kossuth, Mississippi. I'm Jack Ivey here live on the Ivey Broadcasting Company. We appreciate you being with us here today on your hometown station. We got, of course, the ball team's about ready to be called out right now. The coaches are out talking to the umpires here at home plate. Coach Steve Lyles and Coach Jeff Long talking it over with the officials. We're about ready to get this one underway. Big game, big division game here tonight. Belmont knocked off Kossuth up at Belmont the other night. And right now, everybody doing what they can to get in the playoffs. And, of course, right now you're looking at a couple of teams, one of them being the Morville Troopers and the Boonville Blue Devils. They're in good shape as far as Belmont's concerned. And also, Belmont's best hope is third place. Would probably need to get a win here tonight. So you just want to get in the playoffs, but you don't want to be in that number four slot. But you definitely want to get in the playoffs, whatever the case. But right now, the Cardinals and the Kossuth Aggies vying for a spot in the playoffs. I'm Jack Ivey live here. Today's game, of course, brought to you by really great sponsors, including Davis Ford down in Fulton, Mississippi, by Higginbottom's Family Restaurant. Gina McNatt, your Tishomingo County Tax Collector, by Stone's Jewelry in Tupelo and Ripley, Engagement Ring Headquarters. Also want to thank Wildflowers, unique flowers and gifts. Don't forget, they're across from Sparks Drive and Highway 25 South. They, of course, are your headquarters for all your Memorial Day flowers. Call them right now, 454-1033. Also, Redmond Heating and Cooling on our sponsor. Ship residential and commercial install service and repairs. Free estimates, of course. They're licensed, abundant. Once again, 662-279-6569. Also, the Sparks Drive-In on our broadcast tonight, Highway 25 South. Also, Willow Lane Tire Store, Oil Change, and Wrecker Service next to the Belmont Fire Department. Also want to thank Daniel Sparks, your CPA man. Of course, he does it all. He's a lawyer, but he's just what we know as a Belmont Cardinal. He's a Cardinal alumni and proud to sponsor the games tonight. Daniel, thank you so much. Also, Donnie Bell, your District 21 representative, making the game possible tonight. Also, Donnie Trotter and Deborah Farr out of the Insurance Services, 454-0054. Also, Realtor Keith Henley with Tommy Morgan is a big Belmont alumni as well. He knows how it, and what it takes to get that home sold or find your next one. Once again, welcome Keith Henley. Also, the Old Country Store, Highway 25 South in Belmont, a big sponsor of the game tonight. See Scott Will, Caldwell and all the staff. Now the starting lineup for the Belmont Cardinals.
Right field, number 15, Anna Pounds. Batting second and catching, number 22, Caroline Gross. Batting third and pitching, number 8, Kimberly Shook. Batting fourth and playing first base, number 11, Chana Caldwell. Batting fifth and playing short, number 24, Sarah Berryman. Batting sixth and playing third, number 20, Brianna Lynch. Batting seventh and playing second, number 23, Olivia Rooker. Batting eighth and playing center field, number 4, Haley Musgrave. Batting ninth and playing left field, number 32, Chantel Lynch. Belmont is coached by head coach Jeff Long and assistant coach Guy Gardner. And now for your Kossuth Lady Aggies. Batting first and playing second base, number 44, Briley Kate Duncan. Batting second and playing first base, number 20, Abby Lyles. Batting third and playing short, number 12, Jade Barnes. Batting fourth and playing third base, number 9, Presley Tice. Batting fifth, your DP, number 30, Marley Mass. Batting sixth and playing left field, number 54, Arlie Osborne. Batting seventh and playing right field, number 19, Avery Mullins. Batting eighth and pitching, number 25, Macy Mask. Batting ninth and playing center field, number 2, Mason Drury. And catching, number 6, Kristen Swindle. The Lady Aggies are coached by Steve Lyles and assistant coaches Kelly Hopper and Daryl Duncan. At this time, if you'll please stand for the playing of our national anthem.
Oh, see, can you see
Live coverage here on the Ivy Broadcasting Company. Once again, we're live in Kossuth, Mississippi. Hello, everybody. Jack Ivy live here. After joining us on a broadcast, honor to be here tonight. Anna Pounds will lead it off, followed by Caroline Gross, Kimberly Shook, Chana Caldwell, Sarah Behrman, Brianna Lynch, Olivia Rooker, Haley Musgrave, and Chantel Lynch will be the starting lineups for the Belmont Cardinals tonight. Leading it off will be number 44. That will be Briley Kate Duncan. She'll be followed by number 20. That's Abby Lyles. Number 12 will be the third batter. That is Jade Barnes. Also, number 9 will bat number 4, Presley Tice. Number 30 will bat number in the fifth slot. That's Marley Mask. Number 54 will bat 6. That is Arlie Osborne. And also batting 7th will be number 19. We're looking it up on the chart here, Avery Mullins. Batting 8th will be number 25. And 25 is Macy Mask. And batting 9th will be number 2, I guess it is. And number 2, of course, is Mason Drury. And another number 10 slot there will be number 6. And number 6 is Christy Swindle. This is the Ivy Broadcasting Company once again live in Kossuth, Mississippi. We're about ready to get this one underway. If you're out there joining us on a broadcast, once again, we appreciate you being with us here tonight on the Ivy Broadcasting Company. Pitching for Kossuth will be number 25. Is Macy Mass. She's a senior, and leading off of the Cardinals will be Anna Pounds, and we're underway. This is Belmont and Kossuth fast pitch softball. And the first pitch is popped up to the right side. Second baseman there cannot make the catch. The ball drops in. And the Cardinals have a base runner down at first base. So the Cardinals get a quick break here early and get a base runner with Pounds. Kind of getting it out there in no man's land. But I actually thought she was going to make that catch. This will bring up Caroline Gross, the Belmont Cardinal catcher.
Up to bat, number 22, Caroline Gross.
She'll be batting with a runner at first and nobody out. Lays down a bunt. Nice one. Third baseman's got it. Throw to first. It's high, and she's safe at first base. Good hustle. Got her on base there. The throw was high, and she was safe down at first base. So the Cardinals off to a good start and with a couple of base runners. This will bring up number 8 for the Cardinals. This will be Kimberly Shook. She'll be on the mound pitching for Belmont today. And the pitch on the way. Swing, ground ball, off the pitcher's glove. She turns around, throws, and she's going to be safe at first base again. So another runner safe. That one kind of was off the pitcher's glove. Somebody went over and picked it up, and by the time the throw got there, it was awful close. So the Cardinals have the bases loaded with nobody out, and we'll have a courtesy runner down at first base. This will be Brock and running the bases down there for the Cardinals. She catches on the JV team.
Up to bat, number 11, Chana Caldwell.
So the Cardinals have got Caldwell, number 11 batting, first baseman. And she's batting with the bases loaded and nobody out. Macy Mass ready to go, and there's the pitch, gets away from the catcher, and the Cardinals going to try to score. I'm surprised. She's safe. I'm surprised we took a chance on that, but we got away with it, and guess what? The Cardinals are up by a score of 1-0, able to slide in under that one. So the Cardinals being aggressive here early in the game. So the Cardinals have got runners now at second and third with nobody out and a 1-0 lead. And the pitch on the way is a ball high. and got a timeout here. We got umpires calling timeout to go out to talk to Coach Lyles. I really don't know what he was wanting Coach Lyles to do. I don't know whether the fans were getting after him a little bit down there or not. Didn't seem to be from here. And Coach Long, I didn't get it over there in time, just had to take a big jump as that ball was coming at his way. Belmont leads 1-0. We're on, of course, WRMG TV 12 and also Television 97. We're live right behind the plate down here in Kossuth, and we hope you're enjoying our broadcast. Here's the pitch, swing and a slow roller to the third baseman. The throw to first, and she's out at first. That was pretty doggone close. Well, the Cardinals had to hold up at second and third on that one. Now there's one out, and number 24, Sir Grace Behrman will bat. She is the Cardinals' shortstop. Don't forget, if you'd like to have a copy of tonight's game or any of the games we do, they are available on DVD. And there's a swing, ground ball. Shortstop bobbles it, and the Cardinals will score a run. And Behrman will be safely down at first base. And the Cardinals lead 2-0. And this will bring up Brianna Lynch.
Number 20, Brianna Lynch.
So Belmont out to a 2-0 lead right here. Now with a runner at first and third, and here's the pitch on the way. Throw down to third. The Cardinals still base down at second. They threw it down to third, maybe trying to catch her asleep down there. So Belmont's got runners at second and third now with one out. And the pitch on the way. Swing and a foul back. That'll be against the screen, so... So a two-strike count here to Brianna Lynch, and the pitch on the way. Strike three call. Caught looking on that one. That'll be the second out. Now batting for the Cardinals, going to be Olivia Rooker. Rooker will be batting with two out. Belmont leading 2-0 with runners at second and third. You're on the road at Kossuth, you're going to need every run you can get. There's a base hit to left field. One run is in. Cardinals are going to send the other runner. There will be a play at the plate. Chief catcher drops it. And guess what? Heading down to second after a RBI base hit is Olivia Rooker, and the Cardinals lead 4-0. So four runs here in the first inning for the Cardinals. And Haley Musgrave will be the batter. So the Cardinals are sending the eighth batter to the plate here in the top of the first inning. And the pitch on the way, swing and a foul back. Here's the pitch on the way, and Musgrave, ground ball, shortstop, and we got a runner out. I think we had some interference, and the runner's going to be out to be the third out of the inning, and we've played a half inning. Belmont getting off to a great start and leads by a score of 4-0. We're going to the bottom of the first. We're live in Kossuth, Mississippi. On this, the Ivy Broadcasting Company, Jack Ivy on the road with the Cardinals tonight. We got Steve Bates down in Belmont. He's at home tonight with the Cardinal baseball. And we got, of course, Randall Lindsay and the crew down in Red Bay, Red Bay and the Vernon Bulldogs. We were over at Tisch County and the Etiwamba game yesterday. And also we've covered a ton of games, I'm telling you. So hope you've enjoyed our coverage. We had a couple of the Belmont and Kossuth baseball games down at Belmont and, of course, down here as well. Today's game brought to you by Gatlin's Pharmacy. Are you spending too much out of pocket? Maybe you're in one of those donut holes. Have you ever priced prescriptions at another store? Why don't you let Mr. Stanley Page see if he can save you some money? 438-6605. Also, Greg Collier, your 5th District Supervisor on our broadcast, making progress one day at a time. Also on our broadcast today is the Red Bay Hospital, taking care of her friends and family close to home. Good luck from our administrator and all the staff there. Inpatient, outpatient, rehab, transitional care. Board-certified physicians cover that emergency room 24 hours a day. Also, Farm Bureau agent Mike Harris on our broadcast here today, 662-454-9624. Life, home, auto, disability, health, IRAs, Medicare supplements, tax-deferred annuities. Also, Nelson Metals, 454-7500. We buy cans, aluminum, steel, copper, old cars. We even buy your old gold jewelry at Nelson Metals, 454-7500. Also on our broadcast today is Dr. Steve Center and the staff at the Center for Family Medical Clinic, 454-7170. The Belmont Hotel, Ron and Pat Deaton on our broadcast, along with Donald Ray Thomas, your constable on the south end of Tishomingo County.
For the Lady Aggies, number 44, Briley Kate Duncan.
Briley Kate Duncan will lead it off. Today's game also brought to you by Community Spirit Bank, Mike Montgomery to the staff, J.P. Wyman, your hometown state senator, the Deaton Funeral Home of Red Bay and Belmont, by Peyton Cummings, your chancery clerk, Tiffin Motorhomes, by Harden Heating and Cooling, your factory authorized York dealer, Red Bud Supply, Mark Chumley and Scotty Payne, also Mac Wyman, your Tishomingo County corner, and also want to thank 4th Street Grill and Steakhouse on our broadcast here today. We're ready for the first pitch from Shook, and it's on its way. And it's a strike call. Appreciate the Cardinal and the Aggie fans that have made it out to support their teams tonight here on the road in Kossuth. Of course, when you baseball's playing and your softball's playing, and you got parents that naturally goes to see their kids or grandkids and other, so you split the crowd up a little bit, and that's the case tonight. And the two-strike pitch, and there's a ground ball to the right side. And good job there by the second baseman. That is, of course, Olivia Rooker. Good job, Olivia. Abby Lyles, the junior, birthday girl, will bat right now. Coach Steve Lyles, we appreciate you and all the hospitality always in coming to Kossuth. He's coaching down at third base. He's got Kelly Hopper, Daryl Duncan, and Matt Smith all having him out. I believe that's Miss Kelly Hopper down at first base having out. We have one out. Belmont leads 4-0. We're in the bottom of the first inning. A two-strike count to Lyles, a right-handed batter. The pitch, swing and a pop-up a mile high. That one's coming back over my head and out of play. And the pitch outside. So one ball, two strikes, and the next pitch to Lyles. Swing and another pop-up. That one's going to be back. That might make some noise there. It does. Hit the top of the building behind us. That pitch is a ball. Two balls, two strikes, one out. Lyles batting here in the bottom of the first with one out. Got a battle between her and Shook. Here's the pitch on the way. Ball high. On deck is number 12, Jade Barnes. Don't forget, right here where you're listening, of course, you're listening to the softball game. There's a fly ball to left field. Left fielder over to make the catch. And the out.
Up to bat, number 12.
Chantel Lynch over in the left field making that catch. And with two outs, here's the first pitch to the next batter, number 12, Jade Barnes. One ball, no strike, and the pitch on the way. Belmont leads 4-0 in the bottom of the first inning. Sun gradually going down behind the trees there. And, of course, the lights have been on. And the pitch is on the way, a strike. That's three balls now and one strike. She had taken it to a 3-0 count. Two outs. Cardinal infield just inside the bag at the corners. And there's a swing and a ground ball. That one's in there for a base hit. Lynch will get it out in left field, get that ball back into second. And there she is down at first base with a hit for Coach Steve Lyles and the Lady Aggies. So Jade Barnes gets a base hit. This will bring up Presley Tice. She is a sophomore. She'll bat with a runner at first, and there's a ground ball right back to the pitcher, and then you throw to first. We've played one inning, and it's the Belmont Cardinals leading 4-0. This is Belmont and Kossuth softball on the Ivy Broadcasting Company. Once again, we're live in Kossuth today. Today's game, of course, brought to you by John Dennis Yardy, your Tishomingo County Sheriff. Don't forget Belmont Pharmacy, Bill Donald Weatherford and Pam Moore. By Trashed Insurance, Kim and Caleb Wells, Mike Moore, Brenda Purser. By MedExpress of Red Bay, Dr. William Bush, nurse practitioner Kayla Humphreys. By Southeast Surplus, Mr. Edwin Bolden. By Milligan Ready Mix, Old Highway 25 North. By Sunshine Mills, Grace Long Real Estate. By your hometown, Piggly Wiggly. Redmont Pharmacy, H&R Block of Iuka, Red Bay Fulton. By Napa Auto Parts in Belmont. By Ronnie Cook, your modern woodman agent. And by Sid's Trading Company. This is Belmont Fast Pitch Softball. Going to the top of the second, Belmont leads it 4-0. Chantel Lynch will lead it off for the Cardinals here in the top of the second inning. Belmont sent eight players to bat in that first inning. Chantel's the only one that didn't get to bat, if my memory is correct. And here's the pitch on the way. That one is a call strike. That'll even up the count. One ball, one strike. I don't know where these new armbands and calling out numbers and all that stuff has slowed the game down or what, but there's a pop-up to the shortstop rather than just giving a signal or whatever. So seems like it would take more time because you got to give the number, then they got to look at their armband. And
number 15, Anna Pounds.
Like right now, Pounds gets it. Now she's got to look down to see what it means. And now she'll get in the box. Either way, I'm sure it's probably pretty close. 4-0 Belmont. Pounds lays down the bunt down the first base side, and that's as pretty as you can do it right there, folks. Anna Pounds lays it for an infield hit. That was a perfect bunt right there down the first baseline. Had it too far for the pitcher to cut it off, and still a pretty good ways for the first baseman to come in and just put it all nicely there. That was a perfect bunt. Caroline Gross will be the batter as we go to the second person in the lineup. And in the batting order, swing and a foul tip. There's a foul, she'll have to come back. One strike the count with a runner at first, one out, and a swing and a miss. The runner stealing the throw down there, and she is safe. So Anna Pounds gets the stolen base. So Caroline Gross with a two-strike count with a runner down at second. Belmont already up 4-0. on the road at Kossuth. And here's the 0-2 pitch, swing and a miss for the strikeout. So Caroline Gross is down on strikes. Kimberly Shook will be the batter, right-hander, batting with a runner down at second base.
Number 8, Kimberly Shook.
And the pitch on the way, swing and a shot to center field. Center fielder comes in, makes the catch, and that will be the third out of the inning. That will retire the side. We're going to the bottom of the second inning. It's Belmont 4, Kossuth nothing. This is Belmont and Kossuth softball. We're on the Ivy Broadcasting Company. Today's game brought to you by Davis Ford in Fulton, Mississippi, by Higginbottom's Family Restaurant down in Dennis, Lachey Jeffrey and Stella Higginbottom, Gina McNatch, your Tishomingo County Tax Collector, and by Stone's Jewelry. This is the Ivy Broadcasting Company. Back to action here from WRMG. We're live in Kossuth, and the first pitch to Mask is a ball inside. 4-0 Belmont. We're in the bottom of the second inning. Red Bay loses the first game of a doubleheader today. There's a ground ball right back to the pitcher. Throw to first. Red Bay lost it 2-1. Now it's one game apiece, and they're going to have to play another game here tonight. And that will determine on who goes to the playoffs. Red Bay loses that game. As far as postseason is concerned, not going. And the pitch on the way. Swing and a foul back to the screen. This is number 54, Arlie Osborne. All he wears number 54. Didn't have on here what position she plays in the field today. And there's a swing, ground ball to the right side. Second baseman over to first in time for the out. Good job, Olivia Rooker. So the Cardinals, two quick outs.
That's bat number 19, Avery Mullins.
Avery Mullins, a junior, will bat. And Shook's pitch is low. And the pitch on the way, swinging a foul ball to the right side. Told you about a few Cardinals, and I can't show them all to you because they're right down inside that fence there, and I can't find them. There's Coach over here. Is he giving out some signals over? He's probably done one before. There's a shot to the second baseman over to first. That retires the side. Another great job there by the Cardinal infield. We've played two innings, all Belmont. Belmont leads 4-0. We're live in Kossuth on this, the Ivy Broadcasting Company. Today's game brought to you by Stone's Jewelry, Tupelo, and Ripley. Don't forget Engagement Ring Headquarters. Joanne and Teresa, thank you so much. Their objective is to make you happy and save you money. We're talking about Stone's Jewelry, Ripley, and Tupelo. Also, today's game brought to you by the Sparks Drive in Highway 25 South and Willow Lane Record Service. Today's game also brought to you by Wildflowers, unique flowers and gifts. And there's a base hit right up the middle there. And the ball gets away. Number 11, that's Shanna Caldwell. Heading down to second base. Good job, Shanna. We was trying to get our equipment resituated right here. And Shanna jumped on that first pitch and took that ball to center field. Good job, Chana Caldwell. Today's game also brought to you by Redmond Heating and Cooling with Patrick Brooks. Also Daniel Sparks. And also Mr. Danny Bell, your state representative, District 21. We'll get you another shot of Chana out there after this pitch. There's a ground ball, third baseman. The throw to first in time of the out. Caldwell trying to go to third. And she is safe over there. Good aggressive base running there. Time to do a little chore here and tie them shoes up. Got to get them just right. And there she is right there.
Up to bat, number 20, Brianna Lynch.
Brianna Lynch will bat. Belmont with one out with a runner down at third. Belmont already leads 4-0. And the pitch on the way. Just a little outside. Not much, but a little. See the world famous Jerry Hall down here. Lynch crew down there in the Bronx. And the pitch on the way. Inside, ball two. Two balls and no strikes, I believe. Then got it up on the board, and that is a strike. And the pitch on the way. Swing and right back up the middle. It's a base hit. Caldwell will score, and Brianna Lynch set back waiting on that one and takes that ball to center field. That is a good piece of hitting right there by Brianna Lynch. Coach Guy Gardner over to talk to her, encourage her a little bit.
Number 23, Olivia Rooker.
Olivia Rooker will now be the batter. Rooker flies that ball out and is caught. So Haley Musgrave will bat as Rooker flies out.
Up to bat, number 4, Haley Musgrave.
Haley will bat. Cardinals have got one run here in the third, lead 5-0. Got a runner down at first. Musgrave will bat. She got a bat on it, and I think they might have called us for interference going second and third on the runner, so she may have been thrown out anyway, but that's how it ended last inning. And the pitch. Ninth hitter of this inning. We've only scored one run. And the pitch is a strike call. I take that back. That's not true. I don't know what I was thinking. Shannon Caldwell led off here. 1, 2, 3, 4. This is the fifth hitter. So Musgrave is ready, and the pitch low. Here's a 3-1 pitch on the way, and it's a strike call. Runner needs to be going here. 3 balls, 2 strikes, and 2 outs. And the pitch and a ground ball foul. Today's game brought to you by Donita Trotter and Deborah Ford Insurance Services. 454-0054. We have access to all your insurance needs at Insurance Services. And here's the pitch. Swing, slow roller. Pitcher's got it. Throw to first, in time of the out. That will retire the side. As you can see, Belmont still leading 5-0. We're going to go to the bottom of the third. Bottom of the third. This is the IV Broadcasting Company's coverage here live in Kossuth. Honored to have you on broadcast here tonight. Once again, this is WRMG TV 12 and TV 97.
25, Macy Mass.
Macy Mass will lead us off for Kossuth here in the bottom of the inning. I'm Jack Ivey live for the Ivey Broadcasting Company, brought to you by the Old Country Store, Highway 25 South. Mr. Scott Caldwell and all the staff, they're open, of course, 7 days a week. Great food for morning, midday, evening, 24-hour gas pumps. What else can I say about the Old Country Store? One thing, it's awesome. There's a ball foul back. Kimberly Shook on the mound pitching for the Cardinals. And the pitch on the way. Ball high. Caroline Gross. And the pitch is a ball, two balls and a strike. Marley Mask, the batter, batting with nobody out here in the inning, and they're swinging a miss. Macy Mask, I'm sorry. Macy wears 25. On deck is number two, Mason Drury, and there's ball high, ball four. You folks over in Kossuth, don't forget if you'd like to get a copy of this game or any of the games you do, they're available on DVD. We got them back for many years. If Belmont has played Kossuth in football or basketball, for sure, we've got it several years back. Got several softball, several baseball games. And we got them in the archives. Courtesy runner down at first base, number 17, is Casey Jones. Belmont leading 5-0 in the bottom of the third, and Kossuth with the runner at first. And the bunt, nicely done. We'll see if we can get her at first. We do. And the runner gets off the base down at second. The throw down there, she's safely back in. So the sacrifice is completed. Well, she was wanting more than just a sacrifice. She was wanting to beat that out. But Caroline Gross out from behind that plate quickly and got the throw down there. 5-0 to score Belmont. We're one out for Kossuth here in the bottom of the third and are swinging a miss. This is number 44, Briley Kate Duncan. Back to the top of the batting order. Her second chance to hit tonight. And a foul. So a two-strike count now to Duncan. She's a lefty. Kimberly Shook, a right-hander. Belmont's way in at first base and pretty good being in at third base. And a ball. One ball, two strikes. And the pitch on the way is a ball high. Two balls and two strikes, and the Shook pitch just misses. Three balls and two strikes, and the Shook pitch, swing, ground ball. And that one's going to get through there for a hit. Cardinals get it back in a hurry. I believe that's Brianna Lynch getting that ball back in out in center field. Or is it Haley Musgrave? Haley Musgrave. Because Brianna's over third.
Up to bat, number 20, Abby Lyles.
So Abby Lyles will be the batter. And the pitch, swinging and a miss. Kossuth and I with the runners at first and third with one out, trying to cut into that Cardinal lead. Belmont leads 5-0. Coach Lyle still going with the old-timey way here, giving them signals. I guess I'm old school. I like that better because then she would have had to look down her arm, try to figure out what he said. One ball, one strike, and one out. And the pitch on the way. Lay the bunt. It's a foul ball. Good job. One ball, two strikes, and Lyles is ready. Pitch outside. That'll make it 2-2. Throw down to third. Oh, gets away. That's going to cost the Cardinals a run. Throw was wide from Caroline Gross. Off the glove of Brianna Lynch down at third, and that ball took off, and now it's a 5-1 ball game. Swing and a miss for the strikeout. So they've still got a runner at second base. So when I step up to the plate, just know I'm gonna shine. Let's bring up number 12, Jade Barnes, today's game. Told you by Daniel Sparks off to Triple D's Bucket Service on our broadcast. That's a ground ball to the second baseman. She bobbles it. And guess what? Another error on the Cardinals this inning. And another base runner. And that still 5-1, but you just giving them an extra out. You're asking for trouble. And this will bring up number 9, Presley Tice. Today's game brought to you by Triple D's Bucket Service. Barney Brandon and Dustin Dick, they'll try to meet all your high-reach needs. I used them for a pretty good little job this week. We used them to clean our church steeple this week. They do a wonderful job. They're licensed, bonded, insured. Swinging a fly ball to right field. You can call them at 279-7500. Also want to thank Gatlin's Pharmacy. If you're spending too much out of pocket, make sure you give them a call. Triple D's Bucket Service. Also, Gatlin's Pharmacy down in Tishomingo. Mr. Stanley Page on our broadcast. One ball, one strike, one out. Also, Greg Collier, your 5th District Supervisor, along with the Red Bay Hospital. Farm Bureau agent Mike Harris and Nelson Mentals. Belmont 5 and Kossuth 1 here in the bottom of the third. And swing and a fly. That one's going to be foul. Not going to be able to get to it over there. Today's game brought to you by Donald Ray Thomas, your constable on the south end, along with the Belmont Hotel Center Family Medical Clinic. Dr. Steve Center and his staff. I told you about Ken Nelson at Nelson Metals. And a strikeout by the Cardinals. And that will be the third out of the inning. We've played 3 complete innings. Still should be 5-0, but it's 5-1 right now. 5-1 is your score. This is the Ivy Broadcasting Company's coverage of Belmont and Kossuth fast pitch softball.
Chantel Lynch.
Chantel Lynch, the batter.
Hey, Barbara. 13-4 now.
Five to one the score. And Belmont batting here in the top of the 4th inning. Here's the pitch on the way. Low and inside. And the pitch is a call strike. Chantel wears number 32. And where's she playing tonight? She's out in left field. And the pitch on the way. He is a strike call. 2 balls, 2 strikes now. We're in the top of the 4th inning, live on WRMG, TV 12, TV 97. Not good news for Belmont baseball. They're trailing 13-4. It was 13-0 down at Belmont tonight against Alcorn Central. And the 2-2 pitch. Check swings. And the 2-2 pitch, swing and a slow roller. Third baseman's got it. Throw to first. In time for the out. We're back to the top of the batting order and add a pound who had the prettiest bunt that I've seen in a while. Was safe at first. And made the folks happy, I promise you that.
Up to bat for Belmont, number 15, Anna Pounds.
I know Miss Virginia Johnston, who this girl probably claims as grandma, can make the best banana pudding of anybody in the country. Ball inside. I need to ask Anna if she had any of grandmother's banana pudding. I had one the other day. She brought me a big banana pudding. Yes, I shared it. And there's a ground ball. Shortstop's got it. Throws to first in time for the out. So it's moving right along for the Kossuth Aggies right now. They're down 5-1. Belmont with number 22, Caroline Gross, batting. We're live on WRMG, the Ivy Broadcasting Company. Here's the pitch on the way. Caroline swings and misses. That's a pretty pitch right there. Here's the 0-2 pitch and a swing and a foul. Turned on that one a little bit. And the pitch on the way, swing and a pop up a mile high. Third baseman settles in under it and makes the catch. Third out of the inning. We're going to the bottom of the fourth inning. It's Belmont 5-1. 5-1 the score. Belmont on top. This is game brought to you by 4th Street Grill and Steakhouse, along with Mack Wyoming near Chishomingo County Corner, by Redbud Supply, Mark Chumley and Scotty Payne, by Harden Heating and Cooling with Mr. Allen and Ash Harden, your official York dealer. This is the Ivy Broadcasting Company. Marty Bass will be leading it off for the Kossuth Aggies. We're going to the bottom of the fourth inning. And the shook pitch is foul, back and out of play. The head coach for the Kossuth Aggies is right down there. He's been doing this a couple of years. Coach Steve Lyles. And the pitch on the way. And the pitch, swing and a pop-up. Shortstop, center fielder, neither one got it. Somebody's got a call for it. That was probably, should have been the center fielder's to catch if she could have got there. But looked like, I'm not sure if anybody called it, so they was both kind of going after it. So a hit and a runner down at first base with nobody out.
Pinch running number 5, Lexi Fiveash. Up to bat for the Lady Aggies, number 54, Arlie Osborne.
Well, I told you Red Bay lost game number one, so the series tied after two games. They played one game Tuesday. They're playing a doubleheader tonight since Red Bay lost the first one. So Red Bay will have to win game number two to get in the playoffs. So that puts you, Seth, in a little tight there. And there's a bunt. Third baseman's got it. Throw to first in time for the out. Good job, Brianna Lynch. Nicely done there, Brianna Lynch.
That's a plate, number 19, Avery Mullins.
Avery Mullins will be the batter for Alcorn Central. Kimberly Shook still on the mound for the Cardinals. First pitch is a strike. Got a runner down at second with one out. So far, it's been all Cardinals. They got four in the first, one in the third. One in the third for Kossuth as that one's foul back and out of play. And the pitch on the way. Swing, slow roller, third base. Brianna's got it. It's going to take a quick throw. She's got it. Beautiful throw. Score that one 5-3. We've had two of those this inning. That one was a much more difficult play. Not as much time. And Brianna Lynch did a great job.
Lady Aggies pitcher number 25, Macy Mass.
Macy Mass will be the batter with two out and a runner at second. And the pitch on the way. Just a little low. And the pitch, swing, and that one's to the shortstop. The throw to first, in time of the out. Guess what, folks? We got you good news. We've played four complete innings. Your Belmont Cardinals still lead 5-1. We're live in Kossuth on this, the Ivy Broadcasting Company. Today's game, of course, brought to you by Stone's Jewelry down in Tupelo in Ripley, Mississippi. Also want to thank Mack Wyman, your Tishomingo County Corner, by Redbud Supply, by Tiffin Motorhomes, Peyton Cummings, your Tishomingo County Chancellor Clerk, by Community Spirit Bank, J.P. Wyman, your hometown state senator, and the Deaton Funeral Home of Red Bay and Belmont. Kimberly Shook will be the batter for the Cardinals, starting at the top of the fifth inning. And the pitch and a swing and a fly ball to right field. That one is in there for a hit. Shook will make the turn. She's heading down to second, slides in. And she is safe down at second base. And I think she might be happy with that one there. Good job, Kimberly. We'll have a courtesy runner down there for her. Good job, Shook. So Brock will be the runner. So Hannah Brock will be the courtesy runner. Chana Caldwell will bat with a runner at second and nobody out. And the pitch on the way, low and outside. Watch Chana's bat now. When she sees it's she's seriously about throwing that ball, you watch her get that bat cocked and ready to go. There she goes. The ball gets away. Brock will coast down to third base. So Belmont leading 5-1, top of the fifth inning. Much needed win for the Cardinals here tonight, so they a lot riding on this game right here. And the pitch on the way, ball high. And the pitch on the way is a strike call. Two balls now and a strike. And here's the 2-1 pitch to Caldwell. And it hit her. So she'll be safely down at first base. This will bring up number 24 for the Cardinals. Sarah Grace Berryman will be the batter.
24, Sarah Berryman.
And now Coach Steve Lyles heads to the mound. So the Aggies knows the importance of this game as well, so Coach Lyles out talking it over. They are right now behind the Belmont Cardinals 5-1. There's nobody out, and Belmont's got a runner down at third base. This is the Ivy Broadcasting Company. And the pitch and a shot to right field. It's in there for a base hit. The run will score. And that young lady right there is on base with a base hit to right field. That's Sarah Grace Bierman.
At the plate, number 20.
Brianna Lynch will be the batter. And the pitch on the way, swing and a foul tip. Belmont now leads 6-1. And a ball. Sometimes they keep in the board and sometimes not on the balls and strikes. And the pitch on the way. Swing and a pop up to right field. Right fielder comes in and makes the catch. So Belmont will still have runners at first and second, but now with one out.
Up to bat, number 23, Olivia Rooker.
Olivia Rooker will be the batter for the Cardinals. And the pitch on the way inside. And the pitch on the way, ball high. And the pitch on the way, low and in the dirt. Three balls, no strikes, and she takes all the way, gets away from the catcher. It's ball four. Runners are going to move up anyway, but. And now Coach Lyle's making a trip back to the mound, and this time I'm sure he's fixing to bring in a new pitcher. We'll see who that pitcher's going to be in just a second. Today's game brought to you by 4th Street Grill and Steakhouse, also Mac Wom in your Tishomingo County corner. Also, don't forget John Dennis Darty, your Tishomingo County Sheriff, by Belmont Pharmacy. Bill and Donna Weatherford, Pam Moore, by Tri-State Insurance, Kim and Caleb Wells, and Mike Moore, Brenda Purser. Don't forget, when you become our customer, you become family, and we take all the uncertainty out of your insurance. Come see us, whether it's for motorcycles, four-wheeler, boats, RVs, farms, or businesses. We've got a policy that can be tailored to you. We're licensed in Mississippi, Alabama, and Tennessee. That's Tri-State Insurance, 454-3304. Also, MedExpress of Red Bay, Dr. William Bush, nurse practitioner Kayla Humphreys. Also, Southeast Surplus, Mr. Edwin Bolden, your Steel Power Products headquarters, along with Milligan Ready Mix and Sunshine Mills. Once again, Southeast Surplus, your truck accessory headquarters. This is the Ivy Broadcasting Company. Back to action here from WRMG. This one out here, what's her name? What number is she? I'm going to look this up. Number 16 is the new pitcher. And that's Karis Goodwin out there on the mound. Grandmother sitting right here. I got you a good shot over here. And the pitch on the way, swing and a foul ball. This is number 4 batting for the Cardinals. Haley Musgrave. Belmont's got the bases loaded with the one out, and Musgrave the batter. Chantel Lynch is on deck. Goodwin's ready to go. There's the pitch, swing, slow roller back to Goodwin. The throw to first. Actually, they come to home plate for the force. I thought, sure, she's going to throw it first. And by the time I went over there, she threw it home. And that was the best decision because they got a force out. So good job by Goodwin on the mound to bring it to home.
Number 32, Chantel Lynch.
So Chantel Lynch will be the batter. Karis Goodwin is just a seventh grader, if I'm looking at it right. It's pretty awesome. And there's a, right back, and Karis got that one. I thought it was going to get down if it had been trouble, if it had. And Goodwin did a good job, come in, gets two quick outs, and the Cardinals strand the bases loaded. We're going to the bottom of the fifth inning. Belmont still on top. The score is 6-1. 6-1 is your score. Mason Drury will be the batter as we're live on WRMG. The first pitch is inside. Cardinals shook. Still on the mound pitching. And the pitch on the way. Swing, and that's going to be a fair ball. Shook's got it. She'll just tag the runner out. And that'll be the first out. Number 44 will be your batter next. Briley Kate Duncan. Briley Kate Duncan is the batter.
Up to bat, second baseman, number 44, Briley Kate Duncan.
And the pitch on the way. He is a ball. And there's a pitch for a foul. One ball, one strike, and the pitch on the way. It's a strike call. And the shook pitch, swing and another foul back. Still one ball, two strikes, one out. Belmont leads 6-1. Belmont got four in the first, one in the third, and one in the fifth. We're in the bottom of the fifth. Kossuth's only run came in the bottom of the third. And the pitch on the way. Swing and a pop-up to left field. Left fielder over and making the catch. Good job, Chantel Lynch.
Up to bat, number 20, Abby Lyles.
So Abby Lyles, the birthday girl, will bat with two outs. Swing and a miss. And another strike. And here's the 0-2 pitch. Swing and a miss. Strike three. Struck her out. We have played five complete innings. It's your Belmont Cardinals leading 6-1 over the Kossuth Aggies. We're live on the Ivy Broadcasting Company. And today's game brought to you by Southeast Surplus, Mr. Edwin Bolden, your Steel Power Products Headquarters, 454-7484. We fix and service what we sell at Southeast Surplus. Anna Pounds will be the batter, and Anna swinging away. There's a pop-up to the left side. Third baseman there to make the catch. One pitch and one out. Six to one, the score.
Batting for Belmont, number 22, Caroline Gross.
Caroline Gross, the batter for the Cardinals. Caroline hits that ball down. Third baseman off her glove. It is a fair ball. And Caroline on the way to second base. And that gets her happy there. It's a good hustle, not only on the hit, but also hustling down to second base. Good job, Caroline Gross. This will bring up Shook. She got a big double her last at bat.
Number 8, Kimberly Shook.
Kimberly Shook now the batter. Batting with one out, and there's a ground ball. Third baseman's got it. Third to throw to first in time. Now the Cardinals try to run to third. They do. They're safe. So Shook's out at first. Score at 5-3. And over at third base, safe with two outs, is Caroline Gross. Shanna Caldwell will be the batter.
Number 11.
Sidge Trading Company, your Landmaster utility vehicle dealer and Branson dealer. Two locations now. on 72 and also on Highway 25 South Cinch Trading Company. Got all your accessories. Of course, Ronnie Cook, your modern Woodman agent, along with Napa Auto Parts in Belmont, along with the H&R Block, Redmont Pharmacy with J.C. Weeks and the staff over in Red Bay. Swing ground ball off the chest of the second baseman. Throw to first. And she's out at first base. Took him a while to make a decision, but he called her out. So we're going to the bottom of the inning. This is Belmont Fast Pitch Softball, all the Ivy Broadcasting Company. I guess we're going to the bottom of the sixth inning. Bottom of the sixth inning. Today's game brought to you by Grace Long Real Estate, by Piggly Wiggly, Belmont, Iuka, Red Bay, and also your Modern Woodman agent, Ronnie Cook of Modern Woodman. I'm Jack Ivey, live for WRMG TV 12, TV 97. I told you about Sid's Trading Company, Branson, Landmaster Utility Vehicle Dealer. They're also your Bushog Zero Turn Mower Dealer. And there's a pitch high by Kimberly Shook. Don't forget Edwin Bolden now out at Southeast Slurf Plus, Highway 25 South. Davis Ford and also down in Dennis Hickenbottom's Family Restaurant, a big sponsor. And also Stone's Jewelry. That is coming right back in the stands there. And I thought Mr. Shook had a chance at it. I don't know where I can get him in there or not. We may give him an error on that one. Don't forget your steel power dealer, once again, Southeast Surplus. I want to say how much we appreciate Stone's Jewelry. There's a foul down the third base side. Stone's Jewelry and, of course, Ripley and Tupelo, Mississippi. Big Gina MacNett, a big sponsor of the day, your tax collector. And there is a foul. And there's a fly ball to center field. Nice catch out there.
Up to bat, number 9, Presley Tice.
I hit my zoom and it didn't move, so I apologize. Good job out there, Haley Musgrave. This will bring up Tice batting with one out. And the pitch. And the pitch on the way. Swing and a foul back. Hit the pole and then back at the Cardinal fans over there. One ball, one strike, and one out. And there's a ground ball foul down the third base side. Two balls and two strikes. You got 1-2 up on the board, but it's two balls, two strikes according to the ump. And the pitch on the way. Swinging another foul back and out of play. Got some mums moving, and somebody was in a chair trying to get out of the way. And their chair turned over, and they're all down laughing over there because she hit the ground. That would have been the video of the night to get right there, I'm telling you. Still two balls, two strikes, and the pitch on the way. Low ball three. And the pitch on the way. Swing and a shot left field. That one is caught by the shortstop. She just backed up a couple of steps and made that catch. And we're talking about Sarah Grace Behrman right there making the catch.
Up to bat, number 30, Marley Mass.
Marley Mass will be the batter. She'll bat with two outs in the bottom of the sixth. Belmont still leads 6-1. And the pitch on the way, swing and a shot to right field. That one's going to get down there for a hit. Cardinals got her out at first base. I don't think Mass realized that how quick the Cardinals are going to get it in, and the right fielder not only fielded it, but got it in and got her by a step. Great job, right fielder, and that right fielder is Anna Pounds. So Pounds got to it in a hurry, and that is the third out of the inning. We've played six innings. Cardinals lead 6-1. This is WRMG TV 12 and also Television 97 with the Ivy Broadcasting Company. And a swing ground ball to the left side. The throw to first in time with the out. That'll be the first out of the inning. As Berryman is out. Brianna Lynch will be the batter. Third baseman for the Cardinals have made some really, really good plays down at third tonight and with the bat as well. Belmont with a 6-1 lead in the top of the seventh inning. And the pitch on the way. Here's a ball inside. One ball, no strikes. Brianna Lynch is ready. And the pitch is a ball. Karis Goodwin, once again, a seventh grader on in relief. Came in and pitched. Got the last two outs with ease. Last inning. 2-1. The count, 2 balls, 1 strike, 1 out. We're in the top of the seventh inning. 6-1 Belmont, and there's a swing and a shot to the right side, and that one's in there for a base hit. So good job for the senior Brianna Lynch. Olivia Rooker will be the batter. And the pitch on the way. He is a strike.
Be aggressive.
I would think that might be Dad back here saying be aggressive. He's talking to the pitcher out there. And there's a shot to center field. Center fielder going back. And well hit. It's over the center fielder's head. And she's heading down to second. Ball gets away coming in. Standing up down at second base. Wow, did she get a hold of that one or not? Showing her muscle there is Olivia Rooker. Now the Cardinals are runners at second and third. So the Cardinals have Brianna Lynch at third, Rooker down at second. This is Musgrave, number four. Musgrave is ready. The pitch is a ball high. Only one out, runners at second and third. I know the Cardinals would like maybe an insurance run or two. Six may be enough tonight, but you never know. And the pitch on the way, ball outside. And the pitch on the way. Here's the strike call.
Quit thinking and throw.
2 balls and 1 strike. And the pitch on the way. Swing, slow roller, shortstop. They throw to first. in time for the out, but a run does score for the Cardinals. Brianna Lynch scores. That'll be the second out. It's now a 7-1 lead. One strike, the count with two out. Chantel Lynch, the batter. Belmont leads 7-1 here in the top of the seventh in the pitch. Belmont shows a bunt. The throw to first in time for the out. That'll be the third out of the inning. We'll show you the scoreboard right there. There you see it, 7-1. We're going to the bottom of the seventh inning. This one just about over. Cardinals three outs away from a win. Big division win here tonight in Kossuth. This is Jack Ivey live in Kossuth. Arlie Osborne now the batter for the Kossuth Aggies. One ball, one strike. And the 1-1 pitch, swing and a foul back. The pitch. That will even up the count. Hey, if you're listening to us online, do me a favor before this game's over. Send me a little text and let me know you've been listening. 662-423-7602. 662-423-7602. 662-423-7602. Three balls, two strikes, nobody out. Bottom of the seventh, Kossuth batting, and there's a ground ball right back to the pitcher. The Cardinals get the out and are now two outs away from a big division win here tonight. We left off Southeast Surplus a little earlier, one go around, so I wanted to make sure we didn't cut them a little short tonight. Southeast Surplus, Edwin, thank you so much for making the game possible. You need steel power products, power tools. They got them all, and they service off this sale. They got all your accessories to go with it. And your truck accessory, car accessory headquarters. They do a wonderful job. They're Highway 25 South in Belmont, Southeast Surplus. And the pitch on the way, and it's coming right back here at me. Appreciate Sparks Drive in Highway 25 South, along with the old country store, along with Willow Lane Tire and Oil Change. And there's a ground ball, third base side. Throw to first, not going to be in time. It's off the glove of the third baseman. Shortstop picked it up, but not enough time.
Coming to the plate for the Lady Aggies, number 8, Ava Meeks.
So with one out, we got a courtesy runner down at first base, number 17. Let's see if we can find. That's Kaylee Jones. Here's the pitch and a swing and a foul back. Number So no balls and two strikes. Ava Meeks, your batter. She's only a seventh grader for this ball club from Kasu. And the pitch on the way. Swing and a pop-up right over my head. Still in the hole. No balls, two strikes with one out. Hope you've enjoyed our coverage here tonight. Once again, 423-7602. Let us know if you've enjoyed it. 423-7602. There's a line shot to left field. Left fielder got it and got it back in a hurry. But that's a nice hit by the seventh grader down there, Meeks.
Up to bat, number two, Mason Drury.
Drury will be the batter. She'll be batting with runners at first and second. Belmont leads 7-1. Belmont got four in the first, one in the third, one in the fifth, and one in the seventh. And the pitch and a shot foul down the first base side. And the 0-1 pitch, swing, and a shot. Line drive to the first baseman. Steps on first. Double play. Cardinals get a win. Great play over at first base by the Belmont Lady Cardinals. Shanna Caldwell will show you the scoreboard before it goes away. Belmont wins it 7-1. 7-1, a big division win tonight over the Kossuth Aggies. That is going to wrap up our broadcast here tonight. Appreciate you for being with us here tonight. Thank you, coaches, for Belmont. Thank you, coaches, for Kossuth. There's Coach Lyles congratulating the Belmont Cardinals, and of course Coach Gardner and Coach Long, I know, will do the same thing for the Kossuth Lady Aggies. You kiddos do a wonderful job, both teams. We appreciate you, the hard work you do, and good luck down the road. Once again, Belmont wins it tonight. The final score is 7-1. We're going to wait for our favorite part of the night, and that's the prayer at home plate. And after they do that, we'll say good night for our broadcast tonight. Once again, our final score, Belmont has won the game by a score of 7-1. And the girls having their prayer together. Once again, we appreciate you for joining us here tonight on the Ivy Broadcasting Company. Once again, 7-1, Belmont victorious tonight over the Kossuth Aggies. We're going to say goodnight from Kossuth tonight. I'm Jack Ivy with the entire staff and new management of WRMG saying thanks for joining us for Belmont Lady Cardinals softball tonight. The opponent, Coach Steve Lyles, and the Lady Aggies from Kossuth. We'll see you next time right here on the Ivy Broadcasting Company. Good night from Kossuth.